So we learned the five major elements, and now you know what is vata, what is a pitta, and what is a kapha. That is a tiring nature. It's okay, I can totally understand it. But vata, pitta, and kapha. So vata is made up of two elements, air and space. Pitta is made up of fire and water, and kapha is made up of earth and water. So vata, the even if vata, pitta, kapha, they are throughout the body, they have dominant areas in the body. So kapha is dominated in the upper part of the body. So from the lungs and chest, and then urdhva jatrugata. Urdhva means supreme, superior. Jatru means clavicular bone, this collarbone, and then the top part. The pitta is located into the middle part of the body. Okay? And kapha is connected and located and dominated in the bottom part of the body. Okay? Alright? So, the area where you were showing me. Okay? So, that is the location of the
kapha. Sorry, vata, pitta.
Vata. Yeah. Right? So this is a vata. So whatever you are feeling, and now as you have so many challenges on the emotional level, on the mental level, on the basic, you know, you unable to sleep or too carrying too many emotions, holding a lot of things, it's okay. Holding a lot of things and all of that, it's all going towards the mind and body disturbance or disharmony in the body. Okay, so that's where we are doing the massages. Why we are doing the massage in that area is like we want to open up and take care of the vata. The basic qualities of the vata is vata has a dryness quality. Okay, and that dryness will get healed with the oils. That's why in today's session we will have a oil massage in that area. Got it? Because dryness will get healed with the qualities of the oil. How is the oil? Oil is exactly opposite to the dryness quality of the vata. Okay? Good? Alright. So now we will learn yesterday what we learned about you. And anything else?
No.
Okay, so we will learn a breathing today. Okay, so for you, I want you to bring your both finger, tip of the fingers at the base of your lower back, your lower bottom area of the body. Let's call it as a pubic area or groin area. Okay, so now for you, as you were very much disturbed here, very much challenged here, and you know, a lot of sufferings are there, a lot of emotions are there. So let's do this breathing techniques in a little bit of the stepwise. Okay, in a step pattern. So let's have a nice deep breathing and breathe out. And first we'll practice three together. You can watch me, and then I will give some time so that you can practice. Okay, one thing what I observed in you. Don't do like this, okay? It's so much hurt to the
eye.
Just do like this. Put your both palms. Just
feel like something is coming out like a gel form of thing.
Stickiness. Yeah. Let's call it as a sticky substance.
Yeah, but
I will tell you that tomorrow, not today. Okay, so we'll focus on the vata today. So bring your both fingertips at the base. Very nice. And I want you to keep your back straight, shoulders relaxed. Look forward, chin slightly tilted up. Now, inhale. Exhale. My tummy is tucked all the way in. So this is reaching to the back of my spine. That kind of movement should be there. Okay, it's not just going up and down. Connect with all the muscles in that area. We are using a lot of abdominal muscles when we are doing this.
Okay.
Engage your abdomen. That is the key here. Okay, let's do it together. Keep your back straight, shoulders relaxed, chin slight. Inhale, do it at your own pace, okay? Don't force your body to reach beyond your levels, okay? You're just doing with the ease. If your breath is in here, just stay here. If your breath is in all the way up, then go further. Otherwise, just don't go further, okay? Just stay there. Okay. Just stay there. Very well. Did you see the difference? Now, suck in, do it. And stay there, hold. Now, create that pause. Do you see? Observe the length of your breath now. Right? That's where we need to improve. Okay. Do you see? Right? I'm just breathing half. Are you getting it, what I'm trying to say?
Means initially, means I just tried it, we have it, and after that, we just came here. And after that, it's stopping me.
Connection, creating that connection and going deeper into the pattern of the breath. That is what it will make you more strong. Because Vata needs stability. Vata is very unstable. That's the nature of the Vata. Vata people, Vata style, Vata aggravation. That is all going to create this unstable nature in you, which I see in you. Getting it? Right? So, but who is creating this instability in my body? What is the thing? What is the fuel I am feeding to the Vata? Choices of the food, choices of the thinking pattern, and late nights. What is the late night for you?
When we are sleeping.
What time?
Around 12.
12, around 12 is normal, right? So that is where you are disturbing your whole rhythm of the body. And on the weekends, what time?
1.
Right? That's not the normal nature. Tomorrow we'll learn about that, okay? But today you got the point.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? So what is the fuel? Where is the consecutive factor for you in this breathing, in this problem, what you are going through? You are feeding. Where it is coming from, you know that now. What is the wrong choices you have? Or what you are offering the Vata to get more disturbed and aggravated. Got it? Am I creating that for you? And what will be the solution?
Just feeding properly.
That is one. What is the other?
Late night.
Got it?
Mm-hmm.
I can't help you there. I can guide you there. Okay? And also that thing what you told me, that generally we start cooking at 10 and then we eat at 11, 12 p.m. Right? you do everything in the opposite way. Do what you will start at 6, like 6:30, 7, 7:30, you finish. You guys are bachelor. You are in university working, and you must have crazy people around you. Right? Because this is a stage of the life. Age is 29.
Mm-hmm.
Right? 29 is not a something where you have these many things with you. This is the beginning of the real adulthood. Adulthood is already started, but as our modern adulthood. Right? It's not like we are towards the end of the adulthood actually in this age. On the physical level. Okay? That's where you need to think. Where you are disturbing, how you are disturbing, how you are creating a hurricane for yourself on your body level. And that's where this yoga practice, breathing practice, and yogasanas are going to help you to create one of the healing factor for you. The wellness of your vata will be managed with these practices. Okay? So this is one type of breathing techniques. Now, yesterday we learned the which uccharan, oh, today will be A.
Okay.
And that A is going to come from this area where you showed me today. So back straight, shoulders relaxed. Make sure you create a nice mudra, the knowledge mudra, Gyana mudra, right? And keep it at the out of your out. Good job. Alright. Now create, say thank you to the Mother Earth. This is like offering to you. You're thinking way beyond the physical body here. So this is like Mother Earth. Okay? Alright. So back straight, shoulders relaxed. I will chant first. Okay? And then we will chant together. Then I will give you a few minutes just to chant 11 times. Okay? You do mental counting and you do it. Okay? So the main thing, focus, visualization. Now you know wholeness of vata. So you are connecting with that area. Okay? Which are in that area. Okay? So let's do it. Nice, strong, like the way yesterday you felt, right? That you should feel here. But now, if you want to put your hand and observe it, it's okay. Use your right hand. Use your right hand. Are you a righty or lefty?
Right.
use your right hand and then do the same thing, repeat it. Just this is to learn. Once you are good here to connect and see whether I'm doing it properly or not, then you don't need it. Okay, you will do it visually. Okay.
Or anything, no? But I can feel something is when we are taking inhaler or exhaling, twice or thrice I feel the air that is in inside, but there is no vibration. Vibration is all over here only.
Okay, no problem. Did you learn about yourself?
Mm-hmm.
That's what it is. Okay, that has to be there, and that will come. That will come with the when we will do this abdominal massages and opening and cleansing and work and herbal steams and all of that. That will help. Okay, all right, you understand? Now later on, what I observed, the movement, okay, it was like this.
Yeah.
Okay, so you learned this. Third thing, now our main aim in your case is like going to the chakra healing. The root chakra is which gives us the grounding effect. So in this practice, what you are doing, is like whatever the practice we did, it was more focused towards the breathing techniques. But now, if you want to involve the chakra healing into it, so breathing as well as chakra, as well as muscular, as well as like the way we are integrating the things. Okay, now I want you to do this practice with the mudra in it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this is a pinky finger and this is a ring finger. Bring this together.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and we will be holding like this.
Mm.
Okay, and you practice the same thing so the three are coming together. This is called as a prana mudra. Okay, so now this mudra is good in your case to hold it as you have the all the things which you discussed with me during the consultation. All of that. You know, right? What I'm trying to say is like, it's going to get with this mudra.
Okay.
So involve this mudra whenever you feel that nervousness, tiredness, fatigueness, whenever you feel low energy, I'm tired, I'm fatigued, I'm feeling this, I'm feeling that. That is the time you hold this mudra with you. Practice into this mudra. Got it? So you want to try three in this mudra now?
Mm-hmm.
I can do it. Let's do it together. This is going to activate our main root chakra. That's called it as a Mooladhara. Moola means root. Adhar means table, foundation. Adhar, chakra. Chakra means the wheel of the body. So the basic wheel of the body, which is going to increase our vitality, reduce our fatigue, reduce our nervousness, going to help our eyes, our vision, and also the eye challenge what you are telling. Okay, so this is for that. So I thought like I will teach you this one along with the today's session. Okay, so you learn for I, your challenge of I, your whatever you are holding in that area. So this is a prana mudra. Okay, so let's chant it together. Now we are you are focusing on the breath, you are focusing on the mudra, you are focusing on the chakra, you are focusing on the muscles. How many things you are involving in one session, in one sitting? And then you are sitting on the bed, which is a holding the body in a proper position. Okay, like that. So do it with the mudra now. So prana mudra.
Whatever the time allows you, or whatever time you have for yourself, okay?
So give yourself 5 minutes here at the end of the day. So whenever you feel this nervousness, whenever you feel this challenge, emotional challenge, whenever you feel something here in this area, whenever you feel fatigue, tiredness, very challenged emotionally, this is the whole set I want you to do. All what you learned there and what you learned here.
Okay,
remember everything, bring it together. Now, one more observation from me to you. Okay, so when we are doing this app, right? Now you know the rubber, you know the rubber, right? So try to, like, when you start the R, go here and directly go into that muscle. You are very much here many times, and then towards it you stretch the rubber. That's what I observed in you. Don't do that. Keep it strong from here. Try to directly go here and do it. Want to try one more? Go in directly into that area. Start from there. Just I'm giving you that idea, because that length of the breath is not important. The pitch, the strength of the mantra is important. Okay, it's not stretching the R. It's like feeling the, enjoying the. It's like this. That I is going all the way here. Root of the one. Okay? Alright? On the table, under the sheet, face up. I will knock before I come in.
Okay.
Okay, go from the back.
Yeah.
Alright. And see if you can find your diamond.
Yeah.
Diamond on
I
the
know,
table.
I believe
it must be on the table, okay?
It will be here only. I don't think it will be here.
Okay. All right, on the table, okay? So friends, today we are talking about the concept of Vata healing in the body, the concept of breathing techniques which are good for the Vata dosha in the body. So this is all to manage your emotions in the body, your nervousness in the body, and your instability nature, or too much unstable on your mental level, as well as physical level, as well as emotional level. So this set is meant for that. I hope you enjoyed your time with us. This is Aruna Patki, Doctor of Ayurvedic Medicine, a yoga teacher, integrative national massage therapist. I am here to share my wisdom of Ayurveda, yoga, mudra, chakra, as well as the food, herbal, as well as the Panchakarma knowledge with all of you, which helps to cleanse the body from the physical, mental, spiritual, as well as emotional levels of the body. Hope you are connecting with us, you are connecting with Ayurveda, and you are connecting with yoga. Just connect with your breath. Namaste.